Students of English Literature, this is M. Rehman and you are attending the class Oracy Classes of English Language. Students, today our topic is The Merchant of Venice, that is written by William Shakespeare. In this lecture 9, English version lecture, students, we are going to study the rest part of Act 2nd, scene 7th, 8th and 9th. Students, we are trying to prepare you for the examination properly, so you please subscribe our channel Oracy Classes of English Language so that you may be updated not only in English literature, your syllabus, but also grammar related to your academics and competitive exams of English. And please like, share and comment to us if you have any problem. Students, it will be very helpful for you. Now we begin Act 2nd, Scene 7th. Students, you know, this scene opens in the Portia's house again, and in Act 2nd it is happening second time, because in Act 2nd scene 1 you came to know that Prince of Morocco reached there and it was the lunch time, that's why the work of choosing the casket was postponed. Now we resume this action in Act 2nd scene 7th. It is very important to know that what characters are there in this scene and where this scene takes place. Now, Portia's house, scene 7th. This scene takes back to room in Portia's house. Portia enters with the Prince of Morocco. The curtain over caskets is withdrawn. The prince sees the three caskets. Students, you will pay attention to what is written on the caskets. The casket of gold bears the inscription. It means it was written on the gold casket, "Who chooseth me shall gain what many men desire. Who chooseth me shall gain what many men desire." Means whatever many men wish to have, they will definitely get if they choose me. And it is written on gold casket. The prince reads it. The inscription on the silver casket reads, "Who chooses me shall get as much as he deserves." Means, according to his deserving quality, he will get whatever he deserves. Is written on the silver casket. The lead casket bears the inscription, "Who chooses me must give and hazard all he hath." It is very dangerous, this inscription, because it indicates that the chooser will have to put everything at risk if he chooses it. Portia tells the prince that one of the caskets contains her picture. As we have already told you, students, she will marry the man who chooses the casket containing her picture. If the suitors get the picture of Portia inside them, only then they will be able to claim Portia, otherwise no. She will marry the man who chooses the casket containing her picture. The proud prince rejects the lead casket because it bears the inscription which was threatening and dull. He will not take any risk, anything for the cheap lead, because he thought that the metal lead was very cheap. And he was not going to choose it at all, because it's very risky, and other than this, it was very ugly. So he rejects it. He rejects the silver casket too. He thinks that Portia's picture is very precious thing, and silver doesn't deserve it to be kept in. Silver, which is 10 times cheaper than gold, cannot contain Portia's picture. He reasons that a casket of precious gold alone should keep a gem like Portia's picture. Means Portia is worthy to be in the gold casket as a picture. He opens the gold casket and shocked to find the picture of a skull. There was a scroll in it. A scroll means a roll of paper with words. Something was written on it, and it was written, "All that glitters isn't gold." The prince has drawn a blank and he got nothing. He was answerless. Students, here you came to know that वी आर गोइंग अकॉर्डिंग टू द थीम एवरीथिंग इज नॉट गोल्ड, एवरी ग्लिटरिंग थिंग इज नॉट द गोल्ड एंड हियर दिस इज हैपनिंग. द प्रिंस ऑफ मोरक्को वॉज आफ्टर द ब्राइटनेस ऑफ गोल्ड बट इट वॉज अ मिसलीडिंग थिंग. He got a skull and there was not a picture of Portia, that's why he had to leave from there at once. He bids farewell to Portia and goes away. Portia thanks her stars that such a black complexioned man has not become her husband. He had to go. A student, this was the scene 7th from Act 2nd. Now we are going to study Act 2nd, Scene 8th. The secret of the street of Venice. Now we come back to the street. This scene takes place in the street of Venice. We see Salarino, Salario talking to each other. They are discussing just like a common man. Salario says that Bassanio has sailed for Belmont. Bassanio has already gone to Belmont. Graciano has gone with Bassanio. Graciano and Bassanio, students, you remember these names, who went there and with whom? Graciano and Bassanio went there, but Lorenzo was not there with them. Salario says that Shylock had gone to Duke's palace. The Duke went with him to search Bassanio's ship. Means the time has elapsed, the time has passed, and Shylock is getting ready to take the penalty. And these are the activities related to that. The Duke went with him to search Bassanio's ship, but they reached late. He further says that Shylock was very much excited and angry. He was shouting that his daughter had run away with a Christian he was carrying for not sealed bags of ducats, which his daughter had fled away with. Now, Shylock is very angry because her daughter has cheated him, and he not only eloped, but also she went from there with heavy bags of the money and riches. He was crying for his jewels, not for his daughter. He was crying for his precious stones, which his daughter had stolen away from his house. He was very sad. Students, in the theme you came to know the love for. Now you can witness the love for riches, the Shylock's love for riches here. Salarino then says that he met a Frenchman who told him that the ship laden with rich merchandise had sunk in the sea. Now, the mishappening which came to Shylock is that, Salario is discussing, not to the Shylock, that the ship of Antonio has sunk in the sea. He says he hopes that it was not Antonio's ship. Salario praises Antonio's kindness, and they are remembering and recalling the kind acts of Antonio there in the street, and they are discussing. He says a kinder gentleman treads not the earth. Means he was such a kind man that there is nobody in the match of him. He further tells Salario that he saw how touching the farewell Antonio gave to Bassanio, his friend. They are discussing the kindness, they are discussing the friend love of Antonio there. There were tears in Antonio's eyes when he bade farewell to his friend. They are discussing the deed of love, affection, and friendfulness. Students, there is a rumor, and it connects this play very well to the next scene. Now, the scene 9th starts from here. It is Portia's room again, students, in this act 2nd, 1st scene, 7th scene, and 9th scene are in the house of Portia. This scene takes place in Portia's room. This time the Prince of Aragon enters to try his luck. It's very important because so many short questions occur from this part. The Prince sees the caskets and reads the inscription on them. Students, you came to know the inscriptions written on the caskets in Act 2nd, Scene 7th. Now we are in Scene 9th. You see, he rejects the gold casket, saying that that inscription on the gold casket says that he chooses that he who chooses it shall get what many men desire. You know, the man who will choose the gold casket will get what many men desire, but he isn't among many men. He is a special man, so he deserves the best. That's why he chooses the silver casket. Because what was written on the silver casket? On the silver casket, you remember, you try. He will get what he deserves, you know. So he thinks that he deserves the better things, the best things. So he deserves the silver casket here. The proud prince says that he is not among many. He is proud of himself. He thinks that he deserves all that is the best in the world. So this proud prince of arrogance chooses the silver casket, which says he who chooses me shall get what he deserves. He finds only a fool's head in the casket. Students, he reads the scroll. He got a paper inside it, and it was something was written on it. He finds in the casket, and after reading it, he was very ashamed of this act, and he also bids farewell to Portia. Students, this was the last of this scene 9th. You know, in act 2nd, scene 9th, you see, you come to know about the Prince of Aragon. About the Prince of Aragon. What, now there may be a question. What did the Prince of Aragon choose and what was written on it? The Prince of Aragon chose a silver casket. Why did he choose silver casket? You know the reason very well, because he was very proud, and he thought that he deserved the best things of the world. That's why, according to the inscriptions, he got misled and chose the wrong casket, silver casket. In this way, he failed. Students, I hope you liked and come to know and gone through this lecture very well. And keep on watching our channel and the same version of this lecture in Hindi. And to be updated, please subscribe our channel, RSC Classes of English Language. Thanks.